Hi, I'm Kate. In this tutorial, you will learn how to use Google's indexing API to get your website's pages and content crawled immediately. This is especially useful for time-sensitive content on any topic, from live scores to job postings. Before we begin, we want to warn you that Google recommends using the indexing API only for job posting and live streaming websites. However, during our tests, we found that it works on any type of website with great results. As Google recommends, you should not use the indexing API on money websites. Please proceed at your own risk. We also want to emphasize that Google might crawl your website in minutes, but this might not necessarily result in the indexation of the content. It may take anywhere from minutes to days or even weeks before a URL shows up in the search results. It might also not appear at all. There are three major steps to getting your website crawled immediately: installing the free Instant Indexing plugin, setting up the Google API service account, and configuring the plugin. You can use the timestamps in the description to jump to them or to the most common errors that appear after the setup. Step number one is to install the free Instant Indexing plugin. This is a standalone plugin, which does not require installing RankMath. It is also not related to the Instant Indexing module that you'll see in RankMath's dashboard. That tool is specific for Bing, while the Instant Indexing plugin that we're about to see was made to use with Google. In your WordPress admin area, open the Add New page in the plugins section. Install and activate the plugin, and RankMath will have a new section called Instant Indexing. This is where you will add the Google API service account ID in the end. Step number two is setting up the service account. To do that, you can click on Read Our Setup Guide or use the link in the description of this video and use the links in the headings. We will divide this step into three parts. First, go to the Google API console and create a new project. The link for it is in the description. Make sure that you're creating a new indexing API project. Once the screen shows the API is enabled, you can close the tab. The second part of the setup is creating the service account. Open the service accounts page. There's also a link for it in the description. You will need to select the API project that you just created. On the next page, click on Create Service Account. Then, enter a name and a description. This is important. Select and copy the whole service account ID, the one that looks like an email address, because you will need it later. Click on Create and Continue to proceed to the next section, where you need to change the role to Owner. You can use the filter on the top of the list instead of browsing through it. Click on Continue to save that change, then click on Done. You will then be able to download the file that contains your API key by clicking on the three vertical dots in the Actions column and selecting Manage Keys. This will take you to the following page, where you will click on Add Key and select the new Create Key option. Choose the default JSON format when prompted in the overlay, then click on Create. The third and final step of creating an indexing API project is adding the service account as an owner to your Google Search Console property. To do this, you'll need to register and verify your site in Search Console. Open it, select your property on the left if prompted, and then click on Settings near the bottom. Click on Users and Permissions, which will take you to a new page. Do not use the blue Add User button, because it might result in a 403 permission denied error. Instead, click on the three dots next to your account and on Manage Property Owner. A page will open in a new tab. Scroll to the bottom and click on the Add an Owner button in the Verified Owner section. Enter the service account ID, the one you had copied earlier, in the new owner's email address field and click on Continue. Close the tab, return to the page that was open, and refresh it. You should now see the service account listed as a new owner. You can use a single project, service account, and JSON API key among multiple sites. Just make sure that the service account is added as owner for all the sites in the Search Console. Also, you will only be able to request indexing from the corresponding site. Using the plugin on site A to request a crawl for site B will not work. It will result in an error undefined response. Now, step number two, you must configure the plugin. In the Settings tab, paste the contents of your JSON file or just upload it. Then, select the post types where you want the indexing API to ping Google to crawl your website as soon as a post is published, updated, or deleted, and click on Save Changes. For the third and final step, head over to the Console tab on the top of the page. Enter a URL or more in the Instant Indexing section and click on the Send to API button. Make sure that you are using the same version of the URL that is verified on Google Search Console. URLs can have multiple versions, for instance, beginning with HTTP or HTTPS and including www or not. If the HTTPS version is verified there, the URL you should submit to the post should begin with HTTPS as well. The same applies to www and non-www versions. In just a second, you should see a response from the API. You can use the remove option to remove the URL from the index and get status to check if the URL has been crawled. Instead of entering the URLs here and then indexing them, you can do so from the list of posts in your admin area. There, you should find an option to update a post or check its status. You can also use the bulk actions options to get multiple posts crawled or updated quickly. When it's all done, it will take a few minutes for Google to start crawling your website. Now, let's cover two possible errors that might happen after you've finished all the steps. First is the 403 indexing API has not been used in the project before or is disabled. You can start by visiting the URL that you want to be crawled, then retry. Then you can check if the API is disabled by opening the Google Cloud Platform and searching for Indexing API on the top bar. When the new page opens, click on Enable. Second is the error 404 requested entity was not found. In this case, you will need to use the API console to publish or update the page once. Then you can use the Get Status action. We've added a link to the video's description with Google's indexing tutorial. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find other tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/KB.